Once the archer has come to the full draw position, they begin the transition to the final part of the shot. This is the expansion, the release, and then the follow through. I like to say that the execution is the difference between the best and all the rest. Execution is the moment that the fingers are relaxed and the string leaves the fingers and then includes the follow through. I like to think of it as a golf swing. You start the swing and you continue to move all the way before, during, and after you hit the ball. You wouldn't stop when you hit the ball, and you wouldn't try to hit it harder when you hit the ball, but you have one single motion from beginning all the way through to the follow through. And shot execution should be the same way. Once the archer begins expansion, they begin to draw the arrow through the clicker, and as the fingers relax, all the muscles that are opposing bow force on the push and the pull side continue before, during, and after the release to create good execution. Execution errors occur when there's a relaxation either in the front bow shoulder or softness in the back half during the release. These errors in execution usually occur because the archer's focus is in the wrong place, something in external to the shot rather than internal. The most common causes of poor execution are an emphasis on aiming or trying to hold the sight on the target, or if the archer's thinking about the clicker, or if they're thinking about their release. All of those will cause a loss of the tension and the expansion and the good execution and follow through. So it's really important that in this stage that the archer is really focused on the expansion and the execution, because the execution is the most important part of the shot. It's really important that the archer understands expansion and where the expansion comes from. This is the last 2 millimeters through the clicker before the release. As they're drawing the bow, that same drawing motion that brings the scapula around to the back here, they need to remember that feeling and continue that feeling as they then release and shoot the shot. If the muscles here relax, then this whole shoulder unit will go forward as the archer is releasing, and that will cause forward motion of the elbow, the hand to come out, and a collapse or forward release. This often happens if an archer's thinking of just pulling straight back on the string, because as they're thinking of pulling straight back in this direction from the string, these muscles will relax. And when the shoulder unit comes forward, the hand will come out, and then they will only have a rotation in the shoulder joint, and the hand will end up back on the shoulder. If they have good, proper expansion using the same muscles that brought them back around the drawing motion, then the hand will stay in close to the neck and the whole shoulder unit will come around together, dragging the arm and the hand with it. During the expansion, it's important that the archer maintains the front shoulder in a down and back position. If the archer tries to push with the bow arm, then the muscles in the back here will relax, and the same shoulder unit that draws back the bow here will collapse or move forward this way, causing a collapse in the bow arm. One of the most important skills for an archer to learn is to release the string in the smoothest way possible. We start out with a finger release drill. During the release, you really want to think of the string going through the fingers or going around the fingers rather than opening the fingers. It's a common mistake for the archer to open the fingers on release. Usually the thought of opening the fingers will also cause execution errors. So on the finger release drill, you do is have the archer draw back, keeping their fingers curled here, and then on 1, 2, 3 release, and they release, and then look down at their fingers and make sure that their fingers are still curled and relaxed, so that the fingers never open or flare. 1, 2, 3, release. The other release drill that we do is called the release motion drill. With the archer up in full draw, their hand in the full draw position, we want them to move in the motion that the release is supposed to go. Then we'll say 1, 2, 3, release, and the hand will come straight back along the jaw, along the neck, and end up behind the ear with the hand still up and down, and the curled fingers touching the neck. If the fingers leave the neck, that means they're rotating the arm instead of using the shoulder. So just by keeping the archer with their curled fingers touching their neck, they're learning to use more of their back rather than their arm. So really on the release, they should be moving in this direction rather than trying to move in this direction. If they're thinking about going this way, they're gonna get rotation in the arm. If they think about going this way, they're gonna keep their fingers close to their neck and they're gonna be using more of their back. So if they can practice this, looking at this in the mirror and repeat this motion, and then a 1, 2, 3 release, finishing with the curled fingers touching the neck and the hands straight up and down. Just like that, they'll get a nice smooth release and the release motion. The final part of the shot is the follow through. The follow through is just an indication that the archer has done the expansion, the release, and the execution correctly. As the archer shoots, if they maintain all the tensions, the bow should break down and to the left, and the release should come straight back along the neck and finishing right under the ear. Follow through needs to be a natural reaction to the shot, and it shouldn't be forced, but it should show that the archer is maintaining tension in the front and the back all the way through the shot before, during, and after the release.